This episode is sponsored by Sam's Choice Purified. Good ass water, yes. Alright, so we got the movie of Rocko's Modern Life, Static Cling. A movie that's, well, it's on Netflix. You can watch it now. It's been out for a couple of days. A lot of shows seem to be going on Netflix these days. You got the Invader Zim movie that's going on Netflix. You're stepping it up. You're doing great. Keep it up. So, what's the movie special all about? Well, it's based around how would the characters of the 1996 show of Rocko's Modern Life interact with modern times of the world in the year of 2019. Now, obviously, things have changed in the year 2019. It's been, what? Let me do the math. What is that? That's 23 years. I would hope things have changed in 23 years. If they haven't, well, that would be living in a place called Canada. Okay, so you got the characters Rocko, you got Philbert, you got Heffert, Mr. Bighead, and all the others. And you know, they've been doing a pretty good job. They kept the characteristics from the later show. You still got Heffert making jokes and being silly and a big ass cow, and he's always being the comical relief character. You got Philbert, he's worried about things, he's good with technology, and hey, he's one of his friends. Good job. You got Rocko, the main character. You know, just, you know, the movie's called Rocko's Modern Life, so hey, I mean, spoilers, he's the main character. Yeah, what else you want from him?
The 21st century is a very dangerous century.
He's the embodiment of the level-headedness most of the time, and he's supposed to be there for others, and he does a good job for the movie. Now, you got the characters interacting with technology like smartphones and 3D printers and lots of cool stuff and checking out blimps in the sky. Hey, that's cool and all, but, you know, it works. Well, it's a new movie, and why not? We had to bring in the new times. It was time for some changing, and if you ain't changing with the times, you just might get lost. Now, the animation, still really great. You can definitely tell it was a lot more color stylized and the palettes of colors being used. And it might be kind of jarring if you remember how the old show looked with a lot of the older episodes from back in the mid-90s. You know, but hey, it's a movie. It's supposed to be a lot more colorful. It's supposed to look different. And you're supposed to be able to tell yourself that you're watching a movie because the animation and the colors is supposed to stand out. Now, speaking of things that stand out, you got Ralph Bighead, Mr. Bighead's son. In 1996, he was a boy. And now in the year 2019, he's a man. No, he's not a man. He's a woman. This movie is dealing with transgenders. What do I think about transgenders? Man, those aren't real people. I'm just kidding. That was a joke. Now, I think everybody is entitled to be any person that they want to be. They could be a man, they could be a woman, they could be a bitch. It's up to the person to choose. Everybody's got to make their own paths in life and choose their own path to destiny. Now, if this would have took place in 1996, I'm sure this might be how it would have went down. Hey, Dad, I got something to tell you. I'm a woman now. I have no son.
No shit.
But hey, we're in the new times. Times are changing. You know, good times ahead.
I don't think we're in the 90s anymore.
So we also get to deal with, hey, what did I think about the movie? Well, I think the movie was pretty okay. It was fine. It was trying to get a point across. Just trying to show you that times are changing and everybody deserves to be accepted for no matter who they are, as long as they take a shower. Because I can't be dealing with people that smell like ass. As long as you smell good and you take your shoes off when you come to my house, hey, you're good with me. So, you know, I thought this movie was pretty cool. Everybody just wanted to hear my opinion on this movie and, for me to talk about it. And then I think the movie knew if they threw in something really important like transgender in the movie, they would get people to talk about it. And guess what I'm doing right now? We're talking about it. Shouldn't talk about it. The movie special was a nice extension for anyone who's watched the older series growing up, and I would say you can definitely go check it out if you get the chance. And it did fine. You can still watch the movie now if you didn't see the old series, and you would get what's going on. Rest in peace, the Chokey Chicken. Only true fans will remember your legacy. So yeah, that's pretty much all for me. I liked the movie. It was nice. I wouldn't put it up there with The Godfather or anything like that, but if I were to rate this movie, I'd probably give it like a 7.8 out of 10. pretty respectable. So until next time, remember to stay awesome and to take care. Corey out. Peace.